Hallo, ich bin Jan von iDoc.
Hi, I'm Jan from iDoc. In this video, I'll show you how to replace the backlight for your iPhone 7's display. You have to replace it if, for example, the backlight isn't working and is very weak. You may also need to if 3D touch stops working, because the 3D touch technology is integrated into the backlight. In this case, we're replacing the backlight for a totally different reason. The backlight in our iPhone 7 is working, but the home button stopped working, and the connection cable from the home button to the logic board goes through the backlight. To replace the home button cable, you have to replace the entire backlight unit. You can watch a video guide to replacing your iPhone 7's display on our YouTube channel, or use the step-by-step photo guide on our website, iDoc.eu.
Das Display habe ich soweit
ausgebaut. Now I've removed the display. In our case, the home button cable isn't working. You can clearly see that it's torn. Now we want to replace this cable. Because it goes through the backlight, we're going to replace the entire backlight. I've removed the display from the iPhone 7. I've also prepared the display. I've removed the rear panel, the home button, the earpiece, and the cable set up here next to the earpiece. Now we can see the backlight's rear panel. We have to remove it. The 3D touch and several pieces of film are right under it. We have to remove them one step at a time.
Das Backlight ist nicht verschraubt,
the backlight's
sondern verklebt.
Glued in place, not screwed in. I use hot air to detach it. We heat the backlight's frame so we can gradually take it off.
Schritt für Schritt abzuheben. Das Backlight
we have to disconnect the contact before we can remove the backlight. The contact for the backlight is under this little sticker, which we carefully remove with a pair of tweezers. To make things a little easier, I use a piece of tape to stick the cable to the backlight.
Das Kabel direkt am Backlight und dann
then I can desolder the contact down here. Now we disconnect the backlight's contacts, which are soldered to two ribbon cables here.
Zusammengelötet. Ich nehme den Lötkolben und eine
I use the soldering iron and tweezers to grip the smaller ribbon cable and then heat the contacts. Now I've desoldered the cable. I remove the tape to detach the ribbon cable. Because the backlight's glued on and not screwed in, we have to detach the glue. I use a little spudger and a heat gun to detach the glue. I heat the edge at about 190 degrees Celsius or 374 degrees Fahrenheit. Using the spudger, I carefully pry up the backlight from underneath, pushing it gently. I gradually detach the backlight while heating the glue. Two of the ribbon cables are glued together here. Now I also heat the ribbon cables with hot air so I can carefully separate the cables. To make it easier, I attach the cable to the table. Now I heat the cable again. Using the tweezers, I carefully try to separate it from the second flexible flat cable. You can feel the glue heating up. I gradually continue inserting the tweezers. Now we've detached all the glue from the two ribbon cables and the backlight's frame. Now we can take off the entire backlight. We've removed the back of the backlight. To make it easier, I keep the flexible flat cable taped to the table for now. In the first layer, we can already see the LEDs that light up the backlight. We have to take off one layer at a time and be really careful. I use a scalpel and pointed tweezers. Starting in one corner, I carefully lift the first layer.
Diese Schicht ist im oberen
This layer
Bereich
is also
aufgeklebt.
Glued on at the top. I try to just take it off. It comes off a little.
Ah, da sie
but
noch
the glue is still too
ist,
strong, so we use some hot air.
Die erste Schicht haben
We've
wir
removed
gelöst,
the first
also
layer, so we carefully move on to the second one.
Da auch diese
It's
Schicht
also
wieder
really
stark
glued
verklebt
on,
ist,
so I use the hot air again.
Beim Erwärmen der letzten Schicht
When I was
hat
heating
sich die
the
nächste
last
Schicht
layer,
etwas gelöst.
the next one started to come loose too. This time I start in another corner and carefully pull on it.
Bei dieser
we
Schicht
have to be really careful with this layer because the actual
LCD
is right below
LCD.
It. The back of the LCD is metalized using evaporation,
bedampft,
so it's a very thin layer.
Schicht,
we have to be careful not to damage it. We
die
shouldn't even scratch it or touch it with our fingers.
Auch nicht mit dem Finger drauf touchen. Die Schicht hat
the layer
sich auch
came
ganz
off
gut
pretty
abgelöst.
Well. We still have to take a little glue off these
ändern,
edges, and then we can install
Kleber
the new
entfernen,
backlight.
Und dann können wir das neue Backlight aufsetzen. Alle Folien wurden erfolgreich entfernt.
We managed
wir haben
to
auch
remove
keine
all the pieces of film. We
wir
didn't leave any fingerprints,
Backlight
so we can put in the
das
new backlight. I've already prepared it. The
das
backlight is self-adhesive. We just have to pull off the protective film down here.
Abziehen. Ich setze das Backlight
I carefully position the backlight at the lower edge where the home button is. Then guide it past the retaining brackets and just drop it into the display.
Lass es einfach in das Display fallen und nun kann
Then
es
I can press it on at the edges.
Das neue Backlight ist eingeklebt. Wir
the
wollen
new backlight's glued
testen.
In, so let's
Dafür
test it.
Die
we have to resolder the contacts first.
Ich nehme dazu eine kleine Hilfe,
I use the rear
Rückplatte.
Panel to help me protect the new backlight a little.
Damit wir das neue Backlight etwas schützen.
To make soldering easier, I use another piece of tape to hold
fixieren.
The flexible flat cable in place.
Beim Löten nicht ganz so kompliziert. Ich trage jetzt
now
Flussmittel
I put flux
auf
on both cables.
Kabel auf. Dann
then I
nehme
take the
ich
cable from the backlight, position it, and solder the first contact to keep the cable in position.
Kontakt, damit das Kabel in Position bleibt. Und dann
then I solder the other three contacts.
Das Backlight ist neu angelötet und
now the backlight's
um jetzt
soldered on.
Ob wir
to make
Fehler
sure we didn't
haben,
make any mistakes
gibt,
or cause short circuits, let's use a multimeter to check the individual contacts. The multimeter is working, so now we test all the contacts. I take the first one and connect it to the second one. We don't hear anything, so that's good. I take the second one and connect it to the third one, then connect the third one to the fourth one. We don't hear anything, so we didn't cause any short circuits. Just to make sure, I also put the sticker back on. It's just insulation to keep the contacts from touching any other components that might be conducted. Then I also removed the pieces of tape and the rear panel I was using to help me solder.
Die nur als Löthilfe diente. Das Backlight ist soweit eingebaut.
The backlight's installed, but I want to test it before we put everything back together. Because our home button cable is defective, I also temporarily installed a button so we can test it at the same time.
Das Display ist soweit für den Test vorbereitet. Ich habe
now
auch
the display is ready for the test. I also connected the home button, so we test it too. I only leave out the earpiece and rear panel for the test.
Ich nehme das Display und
I take the display and connect the first contacts and then the battery contact so we can start up the device. For the test, I just carefully set the display on top and start up the iPhone.
Und starte das iPhone.
The Apple logo appears, so the backlight's working. As soon as the device has started up, we test the whole screen and of course the home button.
Das iPhone hat gestartet. Wir testen
the iPhone started up. Now we'll test the display and home button. First I check whether the touch function is working right. Looks good. I also test the brightness. The settings work perfectly. Then I test 3D touch, which is also working. Then I go to the settings to test the touch ID. I add a finger. It detects the finger, so touch ID is working. Then I test whether the home button is working, which it is.
Und die Funktion ist gegeben. Die Reparatur vom iPhone 7 war erfolgreich.
We've successfully replaced the backlight and repaired the iPhone 7. The home button and Touch ID are working again. If you liked our video, give us a thumbs up. You have ideas for new videos? Just post them in the comments here on YouTube. Don't want to miss anything? Subscribe to our YouTube channel or check out the latest at iDoc.eu.